Here's my opinion on Jonathan Pryce. This video is brought to you by TatumReport.com. TatumReport.com. Get the link in the description section. Like and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell so you get notifications anytime I go live or make a video. Make sure you still subscribe to my channel. Hit the join button so you can join the Tatum Squad. Like this video, comment on this video, share this video. Let's get into this. Jonathan Pryce. People are asking me to make a comment about Jonathan Pryce. Some people are criticizing me because I haven't made a comment already about Jonathan Pryce. Here's the reason why I have not made a statement or really made a video about Jonathan Pryce, except for right now. It's because there's not enough information. Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, I am not going to come out and defend the police or defend a brother just because the rhetoric is pointing in the direction that the police officer is wrong and that this guy had, he was doing nothing wrong but being a good Samaritan. Here's a few things I want you guys to think about. A lot of people are saying, look, the police just showed up. They decided to pick him as the suspect. That's racism. We don't know who called 911, do we? We don't know what the 911 caller said to the dispatcher, which was dispatched to the police officer, do we? We don't know what the police officer saw when he arrived on scene. Did he see three people standing there and he decided to say, you know what, there's a white lady, there's a white man who's beating up the white lady, but I'm just going to go after the black man. That's probably not how it went. So we need more information to give a better synopsis of what's going on. A lot of people are saying, oh, Mr. Jonathan Pryce, he was pro-cop and he was pro-white people. I mean, he actually made a post, and I didn't read it. My wife told me about this, that he made a post, and it was on the Shade Room. He made a post saying that pretty much his family has caused him to be, you know, more prevalent or to like white women more so than, and there are some terms that he used in there that was pretty explicit that he prefer white women, as if he preferred to be around white people. Kind of like your favorite athletes. They live around all white people. Don't let them fool you. But anyway, he made some statements like that. I think he made some statements also that he was pro-police. That doesn't mean that you won't act a fool when the police get there, depending on how they react to you. I'm not saying he's right or wrong. I'm just saying people need to have their minds open until we see more evidence to show exactly what happened. I don't understand at this point how people do not get the fact that you need to wait till you can get some solid information. Because there's a lot of different scenarios that can happen or that could have happened that led to this point. One scenario could have been the police pulled up and shot the guy for no reason. And that could have happened. Is it likely that it happened? I almost doubt it. But is it probable? It could happen. Anything could happen in a scenario like this. It could have been a case where he arrived on scene, tried to detain the brother. The brother said, I ain't going to jail. I didn't do nothing. And then he started passively resisting. Then the officer decided to tase him, which I don't think is appropriate. Let me give a side note for the taser. I was a police officer 6.5 years on a SWAT team in the most dangerous city in Arizona, and I never used my taser one time. It's not effective. If I got to put my hands on you, I got to put my hands on you. But anyway, he attempts to tase Mr. Jonathan Pryce, and Jonathan Pryce reacted in a way that made him feel like his life was in danger, so he shot him a few times. That could be a possibility as well. But people need to stop jumping the gun. If you're defending a cop, you have no idea what happened. If you're defending Jonathan Pryce, you have no idea what happened. There's some witnesses out there that are walking out saying that the guy had his hands up like this and the police officer just came and just smoked him. Shot him 3 times, didn't for no reason. They didn't even mention that the officer tased him. They just said he walked up and shot the guy. That sounds a lot like Michael Brown. That sounds a lot like Ahmaud Arbery. That sounds a lot like all these other cases that we have seen that people come out and push a rhetoric. They wasn't even there. They weren't even real witnesses. They just saying whatever they think they should say in order to conjure up, you know, some type of firsthand knowledge so they can go viral. But I'm not accusing any witnesses of it. If you saw it, you saw it. All I'm saying is that before B. Tatum make a statement about this, I want to see the body-worn camera footage. Here's a few things that I think are necessary for me to hear to make a judgment. I want to know who called 911. I want to know what the 911 caller or callers said to the dispatcher. I want to hear the radio transmission from the dispatcher to the police officer and to give a reasonable understanding of what he was thinking and what information he had before he arrived on scene. I want to see body-worn camera footage of what the officer saw when he first arrived. Did he see three people standing there? Did he see a black man fighting a white man? What did he see, and why did he approach Jonathan Price first? Or did he approach Jonathan Price first? So I want to see that. I want to see what did he say to Jonathan Price. Was he a respectful officer? Was he a complete jerk? Was he giving unrational or irrational, unreasonable commands? I want to see that thing. I want to see that. I want to see, because it says in the report that Jonathan was he was resisting nonviolently, or whatever the case may be. I want to see, what does that look like? What do you mean he was resisting but nonviolent? Now, I know there's active aggression, there's passive aggression, meaning that you are just defying a police officer, but you're not actively doing anything about it. You're just saying, hey, I wasn't doing nothing, but you're not compliant. I want to see how that scenario played out. I also want to see what led up and what happened when the police officer pulled his gun out and shot. Was it an accident? Did he not mean to shoot the guy? Was he trying to shoot the guy? Did the guy get a hold of his taser? Those are things that I need to see before I make a decision. And I want you guys to follow suit. Don't pick a side. I said this in all my videos. Don't pick a side. Wait till the evidence come out, because I think the evidence is going to be very, very juicy, just like all the rest of the stuff has been. But anyway, I could talk about this for 3 or 4 more hours. I could talk about how people lack understanding of law enforcement. Therefore, they can't even make a prejudgment that makes any rational sense without being biased. To perceive that the officer just attacked him because he was black, that to me is more racist than the idea that the cop presented himself or gave commands to the black man first. You thinking that with no understanding is more racist, in my personal opinion. And I could go on forever about this. I want to hear from you. Write a comment in the comment section. Let me know what you think about Jonathan Price. Do you even know what this situation is? If you don't, Google him, look it up. You'll have more information. But don't jump the gun, in my personal opinion. We'll see. I'll make another video when the information come out and we can have clarity. Make sure that you like and subscribe to this channel. Hit the join button, join the Tatum Squad. We can get all the perks that you want on this channel. And we got some more stuff in store. Also, go to TatumReport.com. Subscribe to Tatum Report. Make sure you do the push notifications. And if God has put it on your heart to help Tatum Report grow and help the mission be fulfilled, I want you to go on there and donate whatever amount. We have people donating $1. That is $1 to God's heart of you donating what you have. I think it'd be a blessing. Anyway, I love you guys. You know what it is. See you on the next one. I'm out.